Hello everyone! This is Carrie with Everwood Creations. Today we're going to use Vectric software and a CNC to make this beautiful sign. In this tutorial we'll show you how this piece was made from the design process all the way through the actual carving on the CNC. Alright, let's get started. Today we're making a simple sign. It's going to be like a nameplate for a door. First, we need to go in and design our project in VCarve Pro. That's what I'm using right here. I'm using version 9.015. I see a new version is available, but for now, this is what I'm using. I do have VCarve Pro, but anything we're doing is simple enough it could be done in VCarve Desktop. And of course, everything I do could be done in Aspire. Whatever software you have will work. We highly recommend buying the software. It totally helps you get the most out of your CNC. So let's start off by creating a new file. It's clicking right here. If you don't have this panel for some reason, you could always go up to File and hit New that way. But we've got it, so let's just hit Create New File. What pulled up here is the exact size that I need, but if you would need to change it, you'd come over here to the Job Size box, and I'm doing a 14 by 5 inch sign with 3/4 inch depth. If you prefer to work in metric, you could just click on this over here, but I prefer to stay in inches. Now, the only other thing that I worry about here is the zero point. A lot of people choose to make their zero point in the lower left corner, but we have found better accuracy in centering to the middle, so that's what we prefer to do. It's purely a personal preference, so whatever your preference is, just make sure you remember. Then we're going to click OK, and we've got a nice blank box here, and now we're just going to draw some text in the draw text box. I'm going to type in the name that I want, and JC Wilson, she's my mother-in-law and she recently moved, so we'd like to make her a nice little sign for her door. And here you can choose from any of the fonts you have installed on your computer. I have a ton, but I've decided on this particular font for now. We've got a height of 2 inches, which is probably going to be too big, but let's just apply it and get it in the document. So yes, this is obviously way too big. And we have a couple of options for resizing it. You see when you select it and it turns pink like this, you've got these boundary boxes. And you can grab one of those and just make it any size you want like this. Or if you know the exact size of what you want, you can go over here to the Set Selected Object Size. And you can do that with the text as well. I know for a fact that I want the words to be 11.6 inches. So I'm going to hit Apply. You see we have a much more reasonably sized text here. Now I want to pull in the other items that we're going to put in here so that we can get a sense of how it fills the space. The first thing that I'm going to do is import a picture. And my mother-in-law absolutely loves Coco Pellies, so I decided that it would be kind of neat to have one of those on her sign, get a little bit of her personality in there. I've just pulled in an image. Now we are going to go to the trace bitmap, and this is a black and white photo, so that makes this part a little easier. And I'm just going to go down here and hit preview and look at it, and honestly I think it traced it really, really well. Now you'll make sure you want to hit apply if you're happy with how it looks. We'll mess around with some of these others when we're doing the other graphic. So I'm just going to hit close, and then one of the things that I like to do is move the picture itself out of the frame just so that I have a better idea of my actual picture up here. And you see, he looks pretty good. And now the other thing I thought would look nice would be some sort of a border or line or something here below her name, kind of make it a similar size. So I have one of those. And this is just a little arrow graphic. We're going to go ahead and go to trace bitmap again, or black and white again. And this one, because it's arrows, it's very angular. So I want to make sure that my corner fit is as tight as it's going to be. Otherwise, you can end up with rounded corners. And then I'm going to preview, zoom in a little bit. And yep, looks pretty good. So remember to hit apply or you don't end up having your vectors. And then again, I'm going to move my picture off so that I can see my vector. All right. Now, obviously, we could try to blow this up to the entire size of the name, but that would be very, very, very large. So I'm going to go ahead and undo that. And I'm thinking, let's do a resize And we're going to bump it up to about 3.5 and see. And then what I'm going to do is do a copy. You can do it with keyboard shortcuts, or you can go up here and go copy, click off of it, and paste. And then I'm just going to move it. See, it draws a line to help you stay in line with each other, which is really nice. And then I'm just going to do paste again. And again, it's drawing that line for me so that I can keep them together. And that looks really nice. And now we have a border that goes under her entire name. Now, when you pull these in, they're three separate pictures. If you select one and then hold down the shift key and select more, you'll select them all. Otherwise, you can do what they call lassoing, and that is draw a box around just those vectors and you'll have them all. I'm going to group those now so that they all work as one object instead of three separate objects. And really all that's left to do is to kind of position these around. I'm just going to use my arrow keys and bump these around a little bit. My little Coco Pelly. Let's see what size he is. I think we're going to bump him up to 3. Just a little bit of extra height there. And I think it might be kind of nice if we tilt him a little bit. Now when you select him, he's got these boundary boxes again. And then out here beyond this boundary box is a little tool that lets you just grab it and tilt it just a little bit. I don't want to tilt him a lot, just a little. And go back to our selection tool. And now I really like the spacing of this, but as you can see, we are not in the center of our platform here. So let's grab all three. We're just going to lasso. And I'm going to go ahead and group this just to make sure that everything stays where it belongs. And then we are going to go to the Align Selected Objects button. And this button is great because it allows you to align things either to the material or to different selections and different things. It's wonderful. You'll use it a lot. But right now, all we want to do is align this to the center of our material. So all I have to do is press this button and voila, it is now in the center. This is just about perfect. All right, I'm going to go ahead and ungroup it so that I can move her name up just a little bit. And I think that looks fantastic. Once we are happy with it, of course, the first thing that you want to do is save. Go up to File and Save or Save As and save your project. Now, what we need to do is make some toolpaths. Just having this design doesn't tell the CNC what it needs to do. So we need to make toolpaths because they're how the CNC knows what to do. We are going to do this entire sign out of VCarve, which means we're going to use a V-bit. So we can do it all the exact same toolpath. And over here in the toolpaths menu, I always double check that my stuff up here is correct. And then you're going to want to hit the VCarve button right there. It's got a little V on it. Our start depth is 0. Flat depth is something that you'll probably use pretty frequently. I don't need it on this one because I am using a 3/4 inch thick material, but if there's a possibility that your carving will go through the material, a flat depth is something that very easily negates that. My tool, I've already got my 60 degree V-bit selected here, and my feeds and speeds I've already calculated. Make sure you calculate yours based on your machine. And then we'll just hit OK. That's pretty much all we need here. Let's call this Coco Sign. And we're going to hit Calculate. Now this is the preview screen, and it is the most wonderful thing to give you an idea of what your carving is going to look like when you actually take it to the CNC. These little blue lines right here are telling you what's going to be carved. And the little red lines are telling you the path of the bit itself. So it tells you a lot of information just in this. But for now, for design, what we're interested in is what it's going to look like. So we go preview selected toolpath right here. And that is going to show us this very beautiful preview of what it should look like when it's finished carving. and you can use your mouse and explore what it'll look like from different angles. And it really gives you a great idea of what your finished product is going to look like. Now, as wonderful as this is, I will say I find that in general, the final product usually looks better than what this looks. But this really gives you a good idea and helps you spot potential problems. For instance, if one of my VCars was too deep, then I would see the background color coming through right here or something along those lines. So this is a really important step to make sure that it's going to look the way that you want it to look. And right now, I am very happy with this. So my next step is to export my toolpaths, and we are ready to get carving on the CNC. So I'm just going to put a little check mark here, and this button right here is Save Toolpath. I'm just going to hit that. I've got it set up for my post-processor. Make sure you're exporting it in the file that your CNC can read. And I've got it to output all visible toolpaths, which I made it visible. So it's toolpaths to be saved or CocoSign. So that's exactly what we want. Save toolpath. All right, and now we are ready to take that file and put it on the CNC and see what we come up with. Alright, here's the piece straight off the CNC. There is some finishing to be done, but as you can see, it already looks amazing. We'll probably round over the edges and give the sign some stain and lacquer, but how you finish it is up to you. If you'd like to see how we finish the piece, comment below or follow us on Instagram. If you enjoyed this video and would like to see more tutorials, hit the like button below and don't forget to subscribe to our channel.